It's official. Saints were warned and didn't listen, now look what Lawmaker is taking from them all. The New Orleans Saints hopped on the protesting bandwagon this past weekend, to prove a point to the president that they will kneel if they want to. Like all other teams and players who set out for the national anthem this weekend, the message seemed to be more about disrespecting Donald Trump than it was about the cause that Colin Kaepernick started last season. Although they were warned, the team didn't listen and are feeling the full wrath of who really has the power with what a Louisiana lawmaker just did to them. The NFL is no longer America's sport or favorite pastime, it's been hijacked by racists who are using the public platform to spread divisive propaganda. It's gotten so out of hand that the President of the United States has had to address the anti-American players personally and tell them to stop. This only fueled their fire and sparked a league-wide protest that consumed every game over the weekend. The Saints were among the teams who decided that after Trump's comments calling out protesters, that they would take part in it too. Despite knowing that there's ramifications that come from this, they apparently thought they were above punishment and made their point anyway. Within 24 hours of Saints players taking a knee, Louisiana State Representative Kenny Havard sent his own message to these entitled players, loud and clear. The only thing that can get a player to do what he's paid to do is to take away the one thing that's the most important to them. The NFL commissioner and even the coaches are afraid, or simply refuse, to do it, but one blunt lawmaker is prepared to step up to the plate to do what's long overdue. The very reason, the Saints, have the privilege and opportunity to play professional football while being paid millions is because someone in uniform died protecting their right to do so, Havard stated after announcing a devastating cut he's proposing. Louisiana State Representative Kenny Havard, R. St. Francisville, said Monday morning that he wants to cut millions in state tax dollars, exemptions, and credits allocated to the New Orleans Saints, the NFL and any of those groups' associated facilities that receive funding, the Advocate reported. Havard's statement didn't specify the amount of state money that he proposed be diverted from the Saints, the NFL, the report continued. According to a 2015 Forbes story, Saints and Pelicans owner Tom Benson was set to rake in an estimated $392 million from state subsidies through 2025. Harvard finally said what everyone else refuses to point out about why this unprecedented move is so important. Disrespecting our national anthem and flag in the name of social injustice is the highest form of hypocrisy, Havard stated. Our free society made possible by our fighting men and women has made available free education, free lunch, housing and free healthcare and is now be considered socially unjust, he added. It is time the taxpayers quit subsidizing protest on big boy playgrounds. I believe in the right to protest but, not at a taxpayer-subsidized sporting event. Do it on your own time. There are plenty of disabled children, elderly and veterans in this state that would appreciate the money. Just how painful would this be to the Saints if passed? Well, if you're the team owner, which Tom Benson is, it could be a loss of $392 million, which is what Forbes projected he benefits from state subsidies through 2025, according to Sarah Palin. Money talks and is more important to players, coaches, and owners than the message they are sending to America and our president. It's funny how irrelevant a point gets when you impose punishment and take away what's really important to these people. It's time to stop paying these players to protest since that's not their job anyway. The report said during the Mercedes-Benz Superdome lease a state will pay Benson at least $198 million in increased revenue from the Superdome, $142 million in rental payments on property Benson owns, $10 million in bonuses for bringing the Super Bowl to New Orleans and $2.6 million in tax breaks. Benson will get another $40 million from private rent payments to a tower he bought as part of the deal. Those in the NFL who support these protests or sit idly by and do nothing about it, grossly underestimated the American people. The sports fan base is largely patriotic and a majority of the people in this country side with Trump on his stance, not the leagues, according to a recent poll. So it's time to start listening to the people who pay these big bills with their tax dollars earn at jobs where political statements like this wouldn't be tolerated while on the clock. Athletes in the NFL should be treated no different just because they can throw a ball better than others.